In 2021, I was able to join the conservation lab at the Carlos Museum to perform an in-depth technical study and conservation treatment on a late period Egyptian corn mummy, also known as a Corn Osiris. This piece is one of the finest examples of late period corn mummies, and it was exciting to be able to contribute to our collective understanding of how this object was crafted and cared for. Corn mummies were likely created as part of an annual harvest festival associated with the ancient Egyptian god Osiris, whose dominion included both agriculture and the afterlife. The eminent importance of barley crops in ancient Egyptian life is powerfully articulated in this object. Barley seeds were made into an Osirian figure, which has been delicately wrapped and buried with the same attention one would expect to find for a deceased royal. The figure was guarded by ceramic balls with the names of goddesses that protected Osiris in the mythical stories of his resurrection. The coffin lid, painted with spells from pyramid texts, is made of sycamore. The figure is coated in bitumen and adorned with a gilded beeswax mask. All these materials carried great spiritual significance to the ancient Egyptians. It was an honor to be able to help prepare the piece for its next journey. My investigation was vital for developing an appropriate conservation treatment plan. This project drew on many resources difficult to access outside of Emory. X-ray facilities allowed me to non-destructively examine the mummy bundle contents. Modified cameras for multispectral imaging helped me identify historic restoration campaigns, and infrared and X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy instruments, as well as polarized light microscopes, were vital for characterizing pigments and other organic elements on the object. By identifying where the historic restorations were on the mask and the types of wax present, I was able to choose an appropriate adhesive that will be easily reversible in the future. Attaching the wax fragments was a fun challenge, as the pieces were incredibly fragile. Rather extraordinarily, some of the resins could be reactivated with deionized water, so in some instances, I was using original material. The bitumen fragments were not as forgiving, and I often had to make discrete paper bridges using toned Japanese paper on the back of the fragments to help hold the elements in place. I also consolidated the powdery polychrome on the coffin, so no more of the protective spells written upon it are lost to time. All of my work was heavily documented, and I strove to use reversible, or at the very least, easily retrievable, materials and methods, in keeping with contemporary conservation ethics. This kind of project is a dream for students. The analytical and conservation challenges presented required an interdisciplinary approach that would not have been possible in most institutions. It was a wonderful opportunity to work with the mentors, resources, and collections of the Carlos Museum.